Hello and welcome to my very first tutorial for davidvhughes.com. My name is David and today we're going to be learning how to lay an artwork into a Photoshop mockup. And for those of you guys who don't know what a mockup is, well, this is what one looks like in its base form. And throughout this tutorial, we're going to be taking it to this final. Now, despite what this looks like, it is not actually a photograph. And it is a file that is completely generated or created in Photoshop, giving you the ability to edit and customize practically everything in it. If you don't like the shadow, you can remove it. If you want more shadow, you can add it. If you want to create a certain tone, if you want to have an overall color, you want to create a hotspot, you can do that. You can customize everything about these, which gives it amazing flexibility. You can make every one of them different if you want, which is really, really great for, and they're really great for creating presentation pieces, portfolio pieces, whatever you need it for. All of my feature photographs on my website are mockups. So let's get started. We're going to lay in this cover art back here first. And just a brief note about the cover art, something that tripped me up initially when I first started using these. You really have to make sure that your artwork is the right size. And you can see this is 72 pixels per inch, which is the, you know, the screen view, the screen resolution for work, and this is what we're going to be using it for. But you'll notice that it's 1667 pixels across and 58 centimeters across. Now most printed artwork is 300 pixels per inch or dots per inch. So you might be okay, but you just got to make sure that your size, your source material size, is actually big enough. You don't want to actually have it small and have to stretch it out, because you're going to end up with some pixelation and distortion. So you want to make sure that your sizes are correct. All right, so let's get started with actually laying in the work here. if you were lucky enough to grab this file off my website, then you'll notice that I have a distinct file structure and layer structure here. Package is for package, disk is for disk, obviously. But we're going to start with this package here. And this layer is the one you want to focus on right now. This is I've distinguished most all of my smart objects object layers with a yellow color. And what you want to do is you want to get into this smart object layer here. And how do you do that? How do you determine if you are in a smart object layer? Well, you look at this icon right here, you notice it has a little sub icon, and that indicates it being a smart object layer. Now, smart object layer is what you want to work in, and it's what you want to lay your artwork into. Well, how do I get into that smart object layer? Well, you just need to double click on that layer. And inside that layer is your smart object window. And you'll notice here that I actually have a little highlight down here also. So you want to, and I've locked it, so you want to actually lay your artwork behind this highlight, but on top of this placeholder. And you can see that this placeholder is actually right here. This is indicated by this turquoise color back here. Oops, what happened? My smart object layer is gone. Well, it's not gone, it's actually just up in my tab. And just so you know, also, if you look up here real close, you can see it says shape 11411 or 1411 PSB. The B in that part indicates that it's a smart object tab. And I don't know what the B stands for. I'm sure some of you already know that, but I don't, and I'm just not curious enough to find out. So what you want to do is you want to actually go back to your, we're going to go back to our artwork here, and we're going to cut and paste this out. And or copy and paste it. And so in order to copy and paste it, you need to select all of it, and then you can do that simply by Command A, and that's the trail of ants around it, and then copy it with a Command C. All right, and then we're gonna go back to our smart object tab layer here, and just make sure that you have the lower part selected, the lower layer. And then we're going to Command V, and that drops it right into place, and it drops it behind the front edge highlight and in between on top of my placeholder there. And that's pretty much it. All you got to do now is just save it, and you can go up to where am I here You can go up to File and save it if you wish, or you could have just you could have Command S'd it. Yes, that's what I'm trying to say. I've had too much coffee this morning, folks. All right, so we've saved it, and we can close that up. We don't need it anymore. But look what happened. It dropped it and laid it in right on the same plane that we have our original work. So that's pretty cool, right? Yes, indeed. I've also included the spine art here. Some folks don't do that. I like to do it. I'm a bit particular. So what do you suspect we're going to have to do here? Well, we're going to open up the spine layer, spine group layer. And you can see I've included a smart object layer for the spine. So we're going to double click on that. This is my spine placeholder. All right. I don't have my artwork open yet, so I'm going to open up my spine artwork. And it is located right here, spine mockup. We're going to open that. And it's opened up into its own little tab, which is not a smart object. Don't get confused by that. All right. So we want to select all of it with a command all. And we want to cut it, or copy it, I should say. I want to copy it. Command C. Go back to our smart object layer, right? All right, and then we can just lay this right on top with a command V. And all we need to do now is just save it. I'm going to close it up. I'm going to close up the original. And as you can see, you know, it's quite small, but you can see that our spine artwork is now in place. All right, so that pretty much that wraps up our package art. All right, so next we're going to take care of the disk, all right, the hero disk. We're going to open up that group, and indicated by yellow, it's our smart object layer with the little icon, all right. Double click on that, and this smart object's a little different because it uses masks as opposed to just having artwork laying on top without a mask. And a mask is what is creating this donut, all right. This is just my placeholder, all right. This is where you're going to lay in the artwork here. But just to clarify, this is a mask right here. And what's happening here is this is actually vector art. I won't get into that right now. This is actually vector art, and what's creating this donut shape is actually just this mask right here. All right. And now if I disable this mask, you can see the whole thing turns turquoise, and that's the only reason that happens is because I'm using a mask on this layer. All right. So let's go open our artwork that's going in place here for the disk. That's not it. Where is it? Disk mockup. All right. This is our artwork here. All right. So that's opened up on its own little tab, and we're gonna grab this. You can see that this is square artwork, but you know what? Since it's sitting inside a mask, all of this stuff on the corners doesn't matter. I could have anything I want here, and this part right here is gonna get knocked out as well. So we're going to Command All with Command A, I should say. Command A to select all of it. Command C to copy it. All right, we don't need it anymore. Get rid of it. And we're going to lay this in right behind this mask here. A lot of times, both of these will be highlighted. You don't want that. So just make sure that this section, this mask area, is not highlighted. You can tell by it because it has a little outline. Excuse me. Has a little outline around this the place where we want to focus on. So that now that that's highlighted, all you need to do is Command V, and that lays it in behind the mask, and we can save it now. All right, it's been saved. We can close it up. We don't need it. And look what happened. Very nice, right? I'll say. So we've got the package done. We've got the disk done. Now all we need to do is do the background. Okay. Close everything up, make it nice and neat. It's a lot less confusing. So my background layer comes locked. So let's unlock it by clicking on the lock icon at the top of the panel. Now I like to use a vanishing point on my mockups, and I'm not quite certain when Photoshop implemented a vanishing point option. I'm working with CS5, so we're going to continue with that. Vanishing point is actually quite cool. I like it a lot, and we're gonna use the vanishing point in order to lay in our background. So how do we do that? The first thing I want to do first, actually, is open up my image that I'm using as a background, and that is located right here. All right, so we're going to open that up. And there it is right here. And what I'd like to do is actually put it up in my clipboard so I can drop it in when I'm ready. So we're going to select all of it with a Command All. And then Command C for copy. All right, now that's just floating up there in the clipboard. And we're going to go back to, we're going to go back to our background layer, which is located down at the bottom. It's not a smart object, however, it does have a yellow little indicator. And then, in order to implement the vanishing point filter, we go up to vanishing point. As you can see, a grid has appeared inside this filter window. Now, it's a little too tight, so I'm going to back it up a little bit. And you can see it's created a plane here. Well, it has not created a plane. I created this plane based on this rectangular cover art shape. And this is included in the file, so you don't have to create this at all. And remember, we clipped and cut and copied our background before, and it's sitting up in the clipboard now. So we're just going to drop it into this plane right now. And that is with a Command V. We're going to paste it in there. And there you go. There's the background image that we're using. And you can see it's not positioned yet because it's still, you can see the outline of it right here. So in order to position it, you just need to basically touch it and drag it. And this lowers it into that plane according to what the plane is. And as you can see, something I don't like about this is that this hotspot, the highlight right here, is in the background. And I kind of want to get this somewhere over here. All right? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over here to the Transform tool. And you can see it's grown some ears here. All right, I'm going to spin this in order to get this highlight area more in the foreground. So simply just click, or just grab the ear there, and you can spin it in any way that you like. And where is it? Okay, it's not quite in the right place. I'm going to continue to spin it. All right, so good. That's pretty much where I want it. Yeah, that's pretty much where I want it. But as you can see, it's still not quite covering the entire artboard yet. So you still have the transform tool. All you need to do is just grab this little ear right here, bring it out to the end, make sure that your artboard is completely covered. And now I've moved the hotspot a little too much, so I'm going to actually spin it even more and put that highlight area right in the foreground, right about in so it's aligning with the hotspot in my work. Whoops, I got a corner that I forgot here, so let's pull that out a little bit. All right, so the entire artboard is now covered by your artwork, your background image. All right, so that's all done, and you can see it kind of like fades off into the background as according to this plane that's been introduced here. Hit OK, and you can see that your background lays in beautifully, and it looks like it's part of the entire image. And you can see that there's some blemishes back there, so I'm just going to go ahead and get rid of those with my spot healing brush. All right, take care of those. And that's pretty much it, folks. Now you know how to lay in your own artwork on a Photoshop mockup. Most of these guys are pretty much all the same. They all use smart objects. They all use them the same way. One thing I could just tell you really quickly is on this stuff, on inside the smart objects, you can get rid of this. This is just placeholder now. You can get rid of that now if you want to. You can save it just without that. That's pretty much it. We've now done all the steps needed in order to create this work. Don't say that. And I thank you for watching. I hope this helps. And please stay tuned. Subscribe to my blog, davidvhughes.com. Come and say hello. I definitely welcome all comments and appreciate your contributions. And if this helped you at all, please let me know. I appreciate your feedback. All right. Thank you again. And so on.